All right, so a few more questions before we wrap up here. I want to keep it obviously under 30 because I need to eat lunch. Two, other people probably are eating lunch, and three, people have to work as well, like me and you, because I know you and I can do this for the rest of the afternoon easily. So a few questions. So do you recommend posting my resume on LinkedIn, letting people know I'm currently seeking a new opportunity? I mean, I think you and I spoke about that. I wouldn't even post your resume on LinkedIn. I would talk about it, but I would do videos of your resume. If you want to post your resume, you can, but I think that's just not going to do that much.
I mean, your LinkedIn profile and your resume should kind of mimic anyway. And so make sure that the content that you have on LinkedIn is a summary of what your resume is.
100%.
You
I
know,
agree.
I mean, because your resume, you can get really, really granular and you can do everything, but what you don't want to do is put all of that information on paper to where somebody can just read and assume that they know who you are.
Right.
If you give them your resume and your LinkedIn profile, they're going to make their own determination and say, well, this is all that I need to know about them. That's not true.
Yep.
You know, that's why the video, the content, everything else that we're talking about here is so much more important. The resume can come when you walk into the interview and you set that in front of the person and say, oh, here's some more information for you. You know, or the recruiter can present that to the client and say, here's a little more detailed information, but here's our reasons why you want to talk to them. Where is all that information going to come from? The videos and the content and everything else that we've gleaned from the interactions that we're having with you as a human being.
I love that. Next question. Are there any online courses that can be beneficial to my professional career that you recommend I take part during this time? For me, no. I think you need to be networking and connecting and making sound personal relationships right now than taking courses. But that's just my two cents. Thoughts?
I mean, I think it depends on if you're, in your career and you know where you're going and you kind of say, hey, this is my career path and everything else, and there are certifications, and I'll use kind of like, a lot of the Agile certifications or some of the stuff on the functional side to where folks are paying attention to those. If you've got the time to kind of go through that, sure, but not in lieu of
Right.
getting out there
That
and
makes
trying to
sense.
network and doing all that other stuff. I
I
mean,
like that.
don't take courses and do that and say, I'm going to do this instead of trying to make personal connections. You've got to flip that on its
Well,
head.
and I'm gonna say this too. Listen, we recruiters have a full-time job networking and making connections. Like, if you're laid off, don't think you're gonna be able to like get on the internet for 2 hours and then like enjoy the rest of your day watching Netflix. You need to be crushing it 8 hours a day. It
Or
is a full-time job. So if you got laid off, one, I'm sorry. Two, email us your information, so we can help you. But also, like, you're gonna have to get to work.
yeah, I mean, it is work. I mean, in relationship building is work. You don't make friends overnight. You don't your
Right.
best friend forever. You didn't walk up to him yesterday afternoon and you guys are now besties. It doesn't work that way.
Wait, but
You
that
know,
worked for us, though.
yeah, but it's an investment. It's an
Yeah.
investment in another human being, just like they're investing in you, and you've got to put the effort in. People can tell when you're half-assing it. Don't
100%.
half-ass relationship building.
I
You
love that.
can't. You're gonna
That's another.
end up in a worse spot than you are now
Yep.
if you try and half-ass this. You can't do it. You can't do it.
I love that. Let's next question. Second to last question, and we'll wrap it up here. Do hiring managers like seeing candidates who are involved with professional groups or within the community outside of work? So I'm interested to hear your thoughts, Ben. I'll say this in my mind, it just my two cents, right? So I always come at it from my two cents. I'm always cautious to not overspeak, and I don't want people to go back to their, and their spouses go, well, Taylor at Vaco told me this, so I'm not going to do it, right? So again, I'm very cautious about that. But in my perspective, hiring managers want to see necessary skills. Now, I think being involved in network activity is great for your personal brand and who you are as a person and to make connections. But if you're wondering during this time, if I need to pick up, you know, a networking group to make it more attractive on my resume, I would pick up a side project in using some sort of development, I don't know, you know, development languages, and spin up a side project before getting involved with something else from a community perspective. But that's just me. Spin, your thoughts?
I think from the community involvement perspective, that is just, it's another opportunity to connect with people.
Yeah.
But you've got to, again, approach it from the aspect of, I don't want to be involved so that I don't have to do things. I want to be involved so that I can meet other people like myself, mm-hmm. and learn and grow and relate with other folks. You know, the best way to network is to ask somebody a question who knows the answer.
Right.
You know, so if you're involved in a user group or something like that, and you ask a question, you can start a dialogue. That is allowing that person to get to know you, what you're interested in, how you think, how you communicate, all of these things that we've been talking about. It's another way to have a dialogue with another human being. That's why you would be involved in something like that. It's the same thing with taking on a project and doing a side project. You do that so that you can show what it is that you've done, so that you can walk through it with other people, talk about how you got from point A to point B, why you decided to build this thing, you know, where the idea came from, all of that stuff. Again, because it allows for a dialogue. It's a two-way conversation. Everything that you do should be focused on how can I have as many conversations with other people about something. You know, you can't talk to yourself and expect to land your next opportunity. You've got to be interacting with other people.
I love that. Last question, we'll wrap it up. What are some good, if people do want to join network, some community stuff, networking opportunities, you know, is there anything that they can join virtually?
Meetup. I know that, yeah. that a lot of the groups, at least I know a lot of the groups here locally, because we're involved in a lot of them and host a lot of them when we're able to get out of quarantine and be around other people. But I know a lot of them have moved to having virtual meetings and presentations and everything else. And so you still have the opportunity to network and engage with a lot of the folks in the groups. They're just doing them virtually. I mean, I know Zoom and a lot of the technology platforms have made it very easy for a lot of people to join and interact and do that. And in some ways, it's probably easier at a time like this to interact with a lot more people on a virtual level from a meetup group than sitting in traffic at 5 o'clock in the afternoon to try and get across town to try and do it, where you can just pop on the video feed and participate. That's a great opportunity to meet people that are doing the kind of work that you like to do at the companies that you want to go to work for.
I love it. That's so good. Well, Spin, Instagram Live family, thanks for hanging out. Spin, how can people reach you?
Best way to reach me, spin@vaco.com. I'm on Twitter @SpinManTV. And if you go on LinkedIn and you just type in Spinman, you'll find me. I'm the guy with the pink cowboy hat and the sunglasses.
I love it. And for those of you who want to reach me, my email is Taylor, Taylor, @vaco.com. All of my social media handles are @TDessen, TDESSEYN. If you do want to email Vaco and get specific help, please email freeyourself@vaco.com. Again, that is freeyourself@vaco.com. Again, thank you again. Everybody stay safe. Spin, I can't wait to give you a hug when I see you next.
Looking forward to it, brother. Everybody be safe. Be part of the solution, not part of the problem.
I love it, brother.
See ya.
All right, bye.